Some of you might be wondering what is going on. Why is it a Tuesday for one and not a Thursday when my normal YouTube videos come out? But there's a good reason for this. This is typically where I sit to record my podcast episodes. I want to, in the future, start recording a video version of the podcast in addition to the audio version. And then I'm going to release those on YouTube on Tuesdays, the same day that these podcasts come out on all of your favorite podcasting platforms. So if you're on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, CastBox, whatever sort of podcasting app that you use, you can find these podcast episodes there. Part of this is to make sure that you, as my YouTube subscriber, are aware that I even have a podcast. And the other part of it is, I know some people like to just get on YouTube and hit the play button, listen to a video kind of in the background, and kind of go about their day. So this is another way that you can get access to the Bolton eBikes podcast. So once again, if there's not a whole lot of action in this video like you're used to, don't worry. That is going to happen on Thursday. Here we're going to jump into the podcast. This is primarily going to be an audio thing, so there's not going to be a whole lot of things on the screen or anything to see here, but I just want you to be aware that the podcast episodes do come out every Tuesday. We're going to start rolling them out on YouTube as well, and our regular videos will come out every single Thursday. Thanks again. Make sure to hit that subscribe button. Hit like. Let's jump into the podcast episode. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Bolton eBikes podcast, a place where you can learn about electric bikes and also anything involving or affecting the use of electric bikes. I've got something really important to share with you today about possibly a new place you could use your electric bike, but there's something you need to do first in order to make that happen. So once again, welcome back to the Bolton eBikes podcast. Let's get back into another episode. I put out a video on YouTube recently about the topic of riding your electric bike in a national park, because up until late 2019, that was actually not something that you could do. But there's good news. Yes. As of August of 2019, so yes, this was several months ago that this happened, but not everybody is aware of this, the United States Department of Interior basically had a discussion about electric bikes, and they had some open public comment about it, and in the end, electric bikes were allowed. Now, they follow the classifications of e-bikes as far as the class 1, 2, and 3, that many states have adopted as well. So there's some rules on exactly what types of bicycles are allowed. Basically 750 watts or less. And then if it has a throttle, that's gonna be a class 2. And then the miles per hour, the speed limit is limited. So class 1, no throttle, 20 miles an hour. Class 2 can have a throttle, also limited to 20 miles an hour. Or you can have a class 3, which can't use a throttle to get up to speed, but can increase the top speed up to 28 miles an hour. Now, I've printed out and I have it sitting in front of me, basically the actual memorandum and the policy that was created for this. And it's pretty interesting to go through and read through it and see what exactly was done. Like I said, there's the classes, and then they talk about the benefits of e-bikes in this. So let me read a little bit about this and why they decided to let electric bikes into national parks. Here it says benefit of e-bikes. This is on the second page of this document, and I'll make sure there's a link to this in the show notes. It says e-bikes advance healthy parks, healthy people goals to promote parks as a health resource by supporting a healthy park experience that is accessible, desirable, and relatable to people of all abilities, and by minimizing human impact through the expansion of active transportation options in parks. Specifically, e-bikes can, so here's things that e-bikes can do. for people going into national parks, increase bicycle access to and within parks. E-bikes make bicycle travel easier and more efficient because they allow bicyclists to travel further with less effort. That's very true. Expand the option of bicycling to more people. E-bikes provide a new option for people who want to ride a bicycle but might not otherwise do so because of physical fitness, age, or convenience, especially at high altitude or in hilly or strenuous terrain. Mitigate environmental impacts. When used as an alternative to gasoline or diesel-powered modes of transportation, e-bikes can reduce greenhouse gas emissions and fossil fuel consumption, improve air quality, and support active modes of transportation for park staff and visitors. Similar to traditional bicycles, e-bikes can decrease traffic congestion, reduce the demand for vehicle parking spaces, and increase the number of visibility of cyclists on the road. So all great things. These are things that are spelled out in the memorandum, like I said. Now it goes on to talk about the policy, where they are allowed or where they are not allowed. And so it's not like you can just ride your e-bike anywhere in a national park. Of course, there are certain areas where you need to go, but this is great news. And the reason I'm bringing this up now, even though this happened several months ago, is because of the BLM, the Bureau of Land Management. Now, that's a department that also falls under the United States Department of the Interior, but currently, e-bikes are not allowed on BLM land. Now, here's why this is really, really important right now, is because all over the United States, there are areas where you can basically have access to this public land. You can go hiking, hunting, you can go mountain bike riding. Yes, mountain bike riding. The BLM actually has a very extensive website dedicated to showing you where the trails are for mountain biking, which is awesome. It's amazing that that's being done. The problem is, what if you are not capable of mountain biking like most people are, and you use an electric bike to give you some assist so you can actually get out and enjoy those same trails? Well, on BLM land, currently, e-bikes are not allowed. So there's all these great mountain biking trails that exist. So this isn't about just opening trails to bicycles in general where currently people are hiking or horseback riding. There are dedicated mountain biking trails that already exist and electric bikes are not allowed to ride on them. So what are we going to do about this? Well, the BLM has currently an open comment period for the next 60 days. Now, I say next 60 days, but that has actually already started. So this ends in June. But as soon as you hear this podcast, I would recommend you go to the show notes. Like I said, check out the link, follow that, and you can make a public comment. Now, when I filmed the YouTube video the other day, I read some of the comments because they're public. You can see what other people have already said and went over that a little bit and kind of addressed, you know, what are the types of things people are saying, either for or against electric bikes. And basically, there's also a document there that shows you some of the things you should or shouldn't say to make an effective comment. But in other words, basically, there were a few hundred comments. I think when I first looked, there might have been 100-something or around 200 comments or so. Now, I don't know exactly how the website refreshes or shows those comments. I don't know if somebody has to go through and approve them or if they just show up every day, how exactly that works. It's obviously not instantly because I know tons of people commented on my YouTube video saying that they had commented on the official government website in support of electric bikes and being used on BLM land. However, those comments are not showing up, but in the corner of the website, I saw there was a thing that said comments received or something along those lines. And instead of showing like 100 or 200 comments when I had first looked at it, shortly after releasing that YouTube video, the comment section was well over 500. So my goal here, and I'm not going to tell you what to say, but my goal is that you are going to take some action right now, go to the government website, make a public comment, and voice your opinion. Just be totally honest. Like I said, there's a document that gives you some helpful hints, or not hints, they're just helpful tips on making an effective comment in a way that's valuable. But I recommend that you take action and you do something right now, because this is your chance to make a difference on where electric bikes can be used in the United States. And it's great that we have the opportunity to do this, but I feel like far too often what happens is these situations come up, there's an open or public comment period, and no one knows about it. So there's only a few comments and we get a very small sample size of people. So literally, I mean, when I looked at the document, like I said the other day, with only 200 people commenting, well, out of everybody in the United States, that doesn't make sense. We should have more comments. To give you an idea of how much land, you know, this could affect. So the BLM manages, I printed this out so I wouldn't get this wrong, over 247 million acres. So to put that into perspective, that's an eighth of the country's land mass. It's huge. And the comments of just a few hundred people are potentially affecting what's happening here. So if you have an e-bike, which naturally, if you're listening to this podcast, you should, but if you have an e-bike, you need to make sure to voice your opinion and make sure that we have an influence. I think if everybody who's listening to this podcast, if everybody who's watching my YouTube videos, and if those people then share with their friends who have e-bikes, I think we can get not only hundreds, but thousands of comments supporting the use of electric bikes on BLM land. And if that's the response that people see who are administrating this, they're gonna say, wow, we had no idea. There were so many people and so many different scenarios of people using electric bikes who could benefit from these trails. And it's not like they have to change anything. Like I said, there's a lot of trails that are already out there. They're already dedicated for bicycles, for mountain bikes. And all they have to do is say, you know what? Everywhere that a mountain bike is allowed, now electric bikes can go too. And that opens up, I don't know how many thousands of miles of new trails. I'm really excited about this. So most of these trails and places are in the West. So if you look on the BLM website, you can find that section I talked about where it mentions all the mountain biking trails. And it talks about trails in Colorado and Nevada and Arizona and California and just Wyoming, basically just everywhere. And there's dozens and dozens of these places you can go to. Now, jumping back a little bit, how does it work right now? Basically, the only place you can ride your bike in some of these areas is a designated off-highway vehicle area, or an OHV area. In other words, those are the places where motorcycles and ATVs and quads and things of that type are allowed. Now, I think that's great. I think there should be areas where you can go have fun with those types of vehicles, but I don't think electric bikes make sense to be involved in those areas, because a motorcycle or something else, they're capable of really fast speeds, they're loud, and I can only imagine somebody trying to ride their electric bike on a trail and they're doing 10 or 15 miles an hour, and you have somebody on a high performance UTV. Some of these things are insanely fast and fun, but insanely fast, you know, they could be flying along at 40, 50 miles an hour on the same trail. That doesn't make any sense. Whereas an electric bike and a standard mountain bike on a trail, they're really in the same speed ranges, in my opinion. And I say that because most people who are riding on a mountain bike trail on an electric bike, they're not riding it like a dirt bike. And if you have a proper class 1, 2, or 3 electric bike, it shouldn't be able to be ridden like a dirt bike. But basically you're going at slower speeds. You're just using the assist so you can get it out there and have fun. And I think that's exactly what the memorandum for the National Park Service explains in detail and makes clear that there are people that can benefit from riding their e-bike in some of these areas. So as a helpful tip, I've seen this mentioned, and I think it's a great idea. If you're not sure exactly what to say, but you want to support e-bikes on BLM land, one of the things you could do is go look at, and I'll put a link in the show notes again, go look at the memorandum or go look at the regulations for riding electric bikes in national parks, and then basically reiterate that same thing. Say, hey, here's some rules that are smart, they exist, they make sense, everyone's happy about these. Let's just take these rules for the national parks and apply these to BLM as well. I think that makes perfect sense. I don't know, honestly, why it's not done already. Now, I did talk about in the video that I put out also national forests. Currently, national forests consider e-bikes a motorized vehicle as well. Basically, a motorized vehicle, like, is it, that's an off-highway vehicle, like a dirt bike or an ATV or something like that. So they're classifying e-bikes into those, and it doesn't quite fit. We're not to national forests yet. So this is the United States Department of the Interior. Once again, that is the same department that oversees national parks where e-bikes are allowed. So there's already success there. And they also are in charge of the BLM. National forests, on the other hand, are an entirely different department. I believe it's under the Department of Agriculture within the United States government. So that's like, it's like a whole different battle that hasn't started yet. So this is the step that you need to take today. Once again, you can do something today to get e-bikes allowed on more public land in the United States. And all you need to do is leave a comment online. It's super simple. You click the link in the show notes. There will be an area where it says comment. There's a little box. You can just type some things in there, your thoughts, where you think e-bikes should or shouldn't be allowed, and you submit it, and you're done. If you don't want to do that, there's ways to mail the information in, but literally it can take less than 5 minutes to do this. So I highly encourage you to do that. Now, I know this is a little bit of a departure from the normal episodes where I either talk to somebody about e-bikes or I give you some helpful tips about electric bikes or try and teach you things, but I think this was super important to kind of take a moment to just pause and say, hey, we have awesome electric bikes. We're having tons of fun on them, but we need to make sure that the regulations throughout the United States are keeping up with the way that e-bikes work and where people want to use them. Because if things start changing and cracking down and we can't use them, that's no fun at all. Thankfully, that's not what's happening. If anything, I foresee more trails, more places being opened up to electric bikes because people realize that they're fun, they're easy to use, and they're not damaging in any way. They're not noisy. They're not polluting or doing smog or anything like that. There's really no downside, in my opinion, to using an electric bike on a trail like this compared to any other bicycle. Now, I understand if some people are into horseback riding or hiking and they don't want bicycles everywhere. I think there are some trails that should be, or maybe they already are, designated, for example, for horseback riding or for hiking, because trails are different. Not every trail is good for every activity. A hiking trail may be terrible for horseback riding. It might be terrible for mountain bike riding. On the flip side, a trail that's awesome and absolutely amazing for mountain bike riding may not be that fun or good to hike on or to ride a horse on. So I think there's, well, what did I say there was? 247 million acres. I think there's enough space for everyone to get along and have fun with whatever type of activity they like to do. So I hope you take a moment to, like I said, take action on this. I know that I am going to do that, and I'm gonna spread this around as much as I possibly can. So if you see this mentioned multiple times in emails or Facebook posts, don't be alarmed. I just wanna make sure the word's getting out there, it's getting shared, and we as an e-bike community, so you and I are in this together, that we have a chance to make a change. So thanks again. I really hope you got some value out of this. I know it's different, like I said, but I just want you to know that every once in a while, there's gonna be something like this that comes up, and I wanna make sure that it's talked about and that people are aware of it. Thank you so much for listening to the Bolton eBikes podcast. I hope you enjoyed that episode, even though it was a departure from the normal things we cover. Every once in a while, we're gonna get into those, and it's important. These are the things that make progress for us. We can ride our e-bikes in more places. Maybe we can ride our e-bikes at different speeds in the future. I think more regulation is not necessarily a bad thing as long as it's doing it in the right way and we're allowing e-bikes to be used to their full potential. I think there's still some holes. There's a lot of things that need to be worked on, but we got to take it one step at a time. So once again, thanks again for listening to the Bolton eBikes podcast. If you have not subscribed to this podcast, please make sure to do that on whatever platform you are listening on. If you're watching a podcast on YouTube, hit that subscribe button. If you're listening to this on Apple Podcasts, hit that subscribe button. If you want to get on my email list and receive a notification when new podcast episodes come out, which is every Tuesday, make sure to go to ebikepodcast.com. Once again, that's ebikepodcast.com. So very easy domain to remember. You can enter in your email address, and not only will I send you regular emails that just say, hey, the new podcast episode is out, you can go listen to it here, but I will also give you a chance to enter to win a free bike. Yes, that's right. I give away electric bikes as often as I possibly can. And I know I've got some really cool giveaways coming up this spring, so I wanna make sure that you have a chance to enter. Once again, I'm Kyle, I'm the owner of Bolton eBikes, but I also just wanna educate everyone that's out there about electric bikes, and I hope you come back for another podcast episode next Tuesday.